the sound on. This time I'm just gonna talk soft spoken style. Let's start off by whitewashing the canvas. Back and forth, back and forth. It's no coincidence that the last time I made a blanket painting video, Bob Ross was blowing up. He was putting new videos on his channel. So I watched a couple of them. And I figured out how to do knife pulls with a tent spike, which I can't find it for some reason. But I just found out that that reason was so I could use an actual brush. Looks like the Grandmaster of ASMR, Bob Ross himself. I've never been triggered by Bob Ross. Maybe I'm just weird. Maybe I really can't be triggered by dudes. That's kind of a running theme if you've been watching me here lately. I mentioned it in a couple videos. Just don't get triggered by dudes. Now, I'll take that back. Massage ASMR does good because he does soundscapes with no talking whatsoever. And you can't tell he's a dude if you turn the video off or just listen to the sound. But, and I watch a few male artists, massage ASMR included, Tirara de Hoylo. I've watched a few No Stars in the Perimeter. But that's about it. If you're a dude and you talk in your videos, I'm not watching it. Unless I just have a lot of respect for you. I watch a little bit of E-Rift. Not much. Things that I respect him, but he doesn't trigger me. He reminds me of an old buddy of mine. An older version of him, of course, but somebody posted him being a bully, which, you know, the post that he made on Facebook was pretty lewd and crude, but they are 30 plus. They're not children. If they were truly uncomfortable, they could have reported the posts and comments, and they could make it hard for him to post, at least. He's just doing his thing. I'd put money on him being a Gemini. I would almost bet money on it. I don't know. Almost don't even care. I take it back. I don't care. But he reminds me of a Gemini. And their humor is just fucking weird. Not to mention he calls himself Uncle E. Uncles, for the most part, are kind of weird. Uncles are usually around because they don't have families of their own. So they just end up kind of hanging around. I know this. I'm an uncle. And I don't have a family of my own. But honestly, where I'm at in my life, I don't want one. I don't want that responsibility of bringing upstanding citizens into this world. least not yet. Now that might change in a year. It might never change. That's the thing. I'm perfectly content with the way things are going right now. It's not to say I don't like change, but I am fairly autistic, so highly functioning autistic, I would say. I've been keeping a regular job. So that alone doesn't really make it a mental illness, it's just a quirk. I definitely have the tendencies. I've been listening to the same probably 10 or 15 songs on my phone at work for, I don't know, 6 months. Maybe not that long. Maybe just a couple months. But I'm still cool with listening to just those songs. I'm sure I'll change them eventually. Put some old favorites on there. Take the ones I got off. But for right now, they're good. There's a really good one on there by, I always want to say Phil Collins. Not Phil Collins. Phil Collins sucks. Peter Gabriel. It's a really sad song. So sad. I made an employee cry listening to it. Grown ass man too. Made him bawl. Cause his dad died probably 4 or 5 years ago. Maybe more than that. But he's still very sad about it. Which I don't blame him, I'm not making fun of him. But I've dealt with my dad's death a lot better than he has. I can talk about it and not get all tired and sad and teared up. Whew, not him. It still makes him tear up just talking about it. The song is really cool, the video. He ends up, the last, I think, year that his dad was alive, he followed him around with a camera crew and spent every moment that they could together. Did a lot of yoga, a lot of walks out in nature, real slow, just however slow it took. Up and down the beach, hanging out at the yogis. Same stuff over and over again, but a little different every time, just trying to live in the moment, soaking up the last year of his dad's existence, talking about old memories, talking about how they're both old, because they were. I think Peter Gabriel was about 50 when he did the video series, or the following around the camera crew. His dad's probably 70. Really good song. Starts out with a real simple piano medley melody. Spine against spine, yours against mine. by his side. Beyond his dead by his side. Come down by my side with me. Another beautiful song. Make sure I got time. Oh yeah, I got time. I wonder if those eyes are gonna see anything that'll make it all sad. Shouldn't have heard certainty. Spent in the doom. No one's eyes have never seen anything that'll make it all sad. Few not prove a saddening tune. They'll cry and mourn, cause you prove me wrong. You should know who that is. A lot of you should know who that is. It was a pastel video. I miss Hermetic Kitten. Do another cover, but this one, I'll do temperatures. Just a mess. Stop the way I'm wired, so could you please help me understand why? Give it to all these stark desires. You're lying to yourself again. Suicide in the soul. How did it all fall? What did it take to get through to you, precious? Why would I? plan on doing a lot more Tool and Perfect Circle covers. They took the place of my favorite band. Or Maynard. It was Nirvana forever. But then it switched. I still like Nirvana. But given Nirvana or Tool, I'd definitely take Tool or Perfect Circle. Even Pussifer. Pussifer's got some really good ones. I'm not sure if that's a Pussifer songs.